Fuck.
Here we go. Ooh.
Driving,
you
gotta find a place to park.
We're at the beach.
From sunrise. Parking. All visitors must exit beach at sunset.
Give you some money.
Here, push my purse.
Get Chuck coming out.
My first trip to the ocean.
What do you think?
It's a little bigger in the river, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm still not getting in it.
Oh, you gotta put your foot in it.
Well, I'll put my foot in it, but...
Okay, go ahead.
We're at Daytona Beach.
Look at your camera, please. Okay.
We're at Daytona Beach.
Yeah, it's a pretty nice day. Okay.
The sand is soft.
Sand is soft.
He's never had his feet in the ocean, has he? Morgan, hey, so just be careful, okay? You don't have your life jacket on.
What is it? A coin?
No, it's a shell. Oh. A real one.
Let's find a shell and hold it up to our ear.
Took him. That doesn't surprise me.
Oh no.
Bo's like, oh no. What are we gonna do? We gotta find Morgan's feet. Blue bags.
Hey, Carwin.
Blue bags.
I'm feeling the sand.
Put his head down.
Not that cold.
It's not cold. It's the wind here on his ears.
Oh, there he's got it.
Bunkaboo.
Pigeons are kind of out of their element here, aren't they?
Ooh. What if it's a New York fan? They followed us.
There's a sign for feeding the wildlife, you know.
These aren't wildlife, these are city life.
There it is. Where's the city wildlife?
Oh!
Hold it.
In your finger, like that.
Get another one. Come over here, Morgan. Come over here. No, don't throw it.
They learn quick, don't they? There's just nothing there.
You win.
Oh, is it, Morgie Doodles? Is it a fish? Oh, it's a jellyfish. Cool.
It's not alive, buddy. The water is like
it. Where are you going? Well, wait a minute. I'll help you. There's nothing to be scared of. What's the matter? See, they stopped. Thank you.
Everybody
has a show. Oh, thank you.
I just have a show.
Oh, there it is right there. Did you want to look at it?
Lot 1. Parking passes to media.
Oh, it's just closed. Come back tomorrow.
Can you feel it, Dodo?
I can feel it.
I can feel it. The Holy Land.
This is the Holy Land, huh?
Yep, this will be a real learning experience.
Transmission.
Me too.
I'll let you know what car I'm going to drive.
Hi, Morgan.
She's not big enough to drive.
Congratulations, you beat Chuck.
Chuck is going to win the race.
Chuck
beat Chuck.
Chuck
beat Chuck.
How was it?
Good. Good.
Did you like it, Morgan?
Did you have fun?
And while everybody's racing, this is pretty excited fans here. It's a pretty exciting race. Yeah.
I hope you enjoy your tour today. Now I'm pleased to present your tour cocktail.
Speedway during practice, testing, qualifying, and racing events. The Great American Race. It's a biz. The Speedway rests on 480 acres, 1 million.
Well, as you can see, we've got a little bit of mess here in the infield. During the Saturday and Sunday, we had the 24-hour Rolex race. Our left, you see these gray light boxes, 288 of them, each containing one 2,000 watt bulb. Now, these boxes are designed in such a way that the foreign driver would get turned, and that driver would look directly into that light box. He or she would not be blinded by that 2,000 watt bulb. It's all done with mirrors. Oh, what an awesome sight it is. This is turn three. Cal, 76 ball. That's one of four we have here in Daytona, each to the entrance and exit of High Banks. Now, during a Wednesday Cup event, we'll put spotters up there. They'll watch out for an accident or rain or debris, anything in their particular turn that may bring out a caution flag. And up there, well, the races are running nighttime now, so it's not quite that hot up there anymore. But July in Florida can be quite humid. According to the current Winston Cup point standings on that day, and the garages are assigned the same way. Now, out of two spotter stands we have here in Daytona, our speedway is so large it requires two sets of spotter stands. This one high up atop the superstretch, and one to our left of the Winston Tower. Now, as I mentioned, besides Winston Cup cars, we race sports cars like the 24-hour Rolex we had here last weekend. We also have the Paul Revere 250 in July. Anyone?
For a lot of NASCAR Winston Cup.
The last lap's a big deal. You won your 200, it's a big deal. The President of the United States is there and you win a race, it's a big deal.
And Michael Waltrip was up there on July 6th when he won the Pepsi 400. It's a picture taken. I'm going to open this back. They write their stories and plug into the reports, email them back for publication the very next day. They have a TV coverage. On the far right below are the luxurious boxes, and those are owned mostly by the sponsors. And last year during the Gatorade 125s, Gatorade brought their top 43 salespeople down here, and we went over, got them in the tram, brought them here on the speedway, and they each got into a yellow T-top Trans Am. We had 45 of them. They sent 43 of them out to Speedway, and they each a driver got into each one with them. They took them for an introductory lap before the race. And the Pontiac people did the same thing for the 500. So if you're a top salesperson for Pontiac or Gatorade, that's one of the pluses that go along with your job. parked up there, about 3,000 of them. So they're going to be busy young men tonight. This building right here on our left is a scoring building. We'll place one person up there for each car that is on the speedway. They'll keep a hand tally every time their car crosses that start-finish line. Well, there are 120,000 people on the front stretch grandstands. 51 shootout with the vehicle. See the motorhomes over here on the right. They finally just finished the time of last year's Daytona 500. We had 17 foreign countries request meteor credentials besides the United States, and we had to build a larger building. At the very back there, we built a lounge for the drivers so they can sit back there, give their interviews with the newspapers. And talked about earlier how we bring it in according to point standings and line them up right here in these roads. Now Daytona is almost like a city within a city. Security force, our own restaurant. If they just give me a bed, I'd never have to go home. Now, look over on our left, you'll see the Winston Trilon right there. That's a three-sided electronic scoring device. Up on top tells us what lap we're on, and from there down the first nine cars on the speedway. Over here on our right is our infield care center.
The infield care center is open on days when the speedway is in use. The facility is staffed by an expert team of doctors and the International Race of Champions. The Rolex 24 hours in Daytona, sports cars, motorcycles, go-karts, manufacturer's car and tire tests. We also host two major classic cars.